And we are back with The Tick. I have no idea how long the game is. Hopefully not too long at this point. It's already kind of starting to wear out its welcome. Time watching the cartoon. I never knew he was such a dancer. Also, I guess he does do that twinkle toes stuff. Academy of Ninja World Sciences. Okay, is that the science of stopping someone's heart? Maybe in the comics. They wouldn't go there in the cartoon. If you've watched my previous videos and not been sure what I've ever been talking about when I talk about padding, this is the definition of padding. This is what I liked Danny Phantom for not doing. Because this is insane. Said is I really do like the graphics. I mean, that's a really cool tick. All the characters look good. It looks decent. But I mean, wants to just take out my commentary. Just show the video of me just slowly wailing on these enemies. That'll say all there is to say about this game. It would be a little cruel to you, you probably wouldn't make it through. But at that point, you could imagine what I'm going through actually playing it. I think I got through that without losing a life. That's something. Change. I'm not sure what it is. Sounds really like horror movie music now. Mixed with some kind of banjo. Helpful. I feel like I need to make a little more effort to be entertaining. It's a lot harder to talk about a repetitive game than it is one that actually does things. There's only so many times you can say, I'm kicking ninjas now. There's only so many different words that mean that same thing. I can just start counting kicks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. I'm not even sure I'm keeping accurate count. The animation's a little wonky on that last one. It looks like two kicks just put into one. Like he's not sure if he's in a regular kick or a roundhouse. It's a pot! Alright, I think I got two of them with it. That was special. Yes, yes, spoon indeed, Tick. A boss! Or another one. A full-on version of the theme song. Nice jazzy version, too. Ooh. I assume his legs are supposed to extend like that. That's like his power or something. Can't use Arthur. You can't use Arthur anywhere you might need him, apparently. Can I just keep jump kicking? Maybe? I don't actually know if it does damage or anything. I assume it does. I mean, it's a kick still. Even if I'm in the air. Okay! The jump kick is our key. Chapter 5, the Idea Men have landed. Are there new enemies? That would be exceptional. Holy crap. That's gonna be all that guy, isn't it? Now we have light gray suits and dark gray suits. Maybe later we'll have a black and white suit. Holy crap! That's gonna be amazing, I can't wait for that! A blue suit, whoa! And I haven't seen any of these guys attack yet. I assume they know how to use those guns. Someone fired something! What are you about to say? I don't think they have triggers. Or they don't have fingers. Either one would work, really. Really? I think they're easier than the ninjas were. Pretty sure at this point, Sea Urchin has been the only stage hazard in the game that we've seen so far. Aside from the pits and the roof jumping sections, but that seems to be kind of its own thing, so. Thanks, Urchin. Or C. Okay. American made! In China! Those big ones are like flamethrowers or Gatling guns or something, and they are just never trained to use them. Dodging different stuff now, too. Except it all moves in the same patterns. Oh, except for the missiles. I have reached the top of the world now. There we go. Health. I just want to reach the end. Oh, I hit jump. See, now I'm starting to sound like a YouTuber. Man, that was so cheap. That bullet didn't just go through me. Ah, woo. That was close. Spoon. I didn't know the Tick was into graffiti art. Ah! Dodge him! Yeah, these guys are way easier than ninjas were. That just makes me think the game designers had no clue what they were doing. Gee, this is the same roof I was on in the beginning, too. It's like the exact same roof. Except I think the one before might have had a big X on it or something. Oh! Another actual guy. To not be able to hit him. I think they're invincible a bit after being hit, but they're not flashing, so you can't tell when it ends. Got him. A street? Holy crap, who'd have guessed? At least it's not blue. I guess that's worth something. Deflator Mouse. Who doesn't attack. Thanks, dude. Is that like an in-joke or something that I forgot about? Is he just there to make my life harder? If he is, funny joke, but... Oh, I guess that was it. He really was just there to make my life harder. Copy-pasted that manhole from the blue levels. So that just looks completely out of place on this gray street. It's like it exists in an alternate dimension where it is nighttime. Tick himself kind of looks out of place. It'd probably be fine if he had like a black outline, but he also looks like he should be in shadow or something. He looks fine in the dark areas, but here in the light areas, he just looks kind of pasted in. I mean, I know he's completely blue in the show and the comics and stuff. I don't know. Something about it looks wonky. At least to me. I guess, since I have nothing else to say at this point, I will reiterate it again if it's not clear enough. I can already say this game should have been half the length it is. At least half. There was no reason for it to be this long. This is the kind of thing that should be like a simple little beat-em-up for fans of the series. That's what it should be. Don't try to drag it out to be some big experience. Face Chippendale throws a party. I mean, they wouldn't have to cut any levels or anything. Just take out half the enemies. That's all you have to do. You'd probably even leave in the running across the rooftop sections. Because those are nice little break up from the rest of it, but... Good God! Hey, a different guy. And a greener suit than the other green guys. whoa! Did massive damage to me and the console! What the hell? Don't do that! I don't think the SNES likes that! Or at least the Retron I'm using. I don't know about the SNES. SNES wasn't prone to slowdown, but it could have slowdown every now and then. Certainly didn't have the slowdown of the NES. I'd even want to take out more than half the enemies. Cut it down to like a third of its current length. That might be perfect. That might be the sweet spot. You can just play through it in like an hour and... Of course, I don't actually know how long it is. Gotta be at least halfway through, right? If I'm not... I don't even know what to say to that. We've been playing for more than an hour already, between this and the first episode, and we're on level 6. That's insane for a platformer! Not even a platformer, beat 'em up. Sorry. I completely misspoke. Most other beat 'em ups, I would be pretty much done by now. This is insane! It doesn't stop! Did they think the game was so good that people would want to play it forever? Or is there one of those games where there's no ending, so they just made it so hard and stupid that nobody would want to finish it? Don't throw a grenade! No! The frame rate! Oh, everyone's fine. Thank you. arrow, is that his gun coming up from off screen? I guess I kind of missed it. It looked like an arrow pointing that way. No, I just noticed the score on the top of the screen. What is the point of keeping score when it's only one player and you have to kill every single enemy to continue anyway? Won't everyone end up with the same score? Honestly? I mean, if you beat the game, you have the same score, I would assume, unless there's something I'm missing about it. Ooh, a new setting. A dining room. At least the backgrounds aren't as repetitive as the enemies are. I will give it that. And they're repetitive, don't get me wrong, but that's the Flater Mouse, isn't it? I was afraid of that. Couldn't even get to him because the Flater Mouse was in the way. Oh, for crying out loud. Okay. I'm going to call it here for today. Here's hoping there's not too much more. I don't like being negative about games, but holy crap, this game! And we will continue to remember the tick on the Super Nintendo next time. Later!